Good evening, Impact 100 Garden State members, guests including our nonprofit community, sister Impact chapters, sponsors, CFNJ partners, and of course, our 10 finalists. My name is Debbie Semmy. I am president of Impact 100 Garden State, and on behalf of our leadership team, I am very happy to welcome you to our 2021 annual awards meeting. It would be so wonderful if we could be meeting together tonight in person because we have so much to celebrate. In the midst of the worst pandemic in 100 years, we have kept moving forward, and so did the 10 nonprofits who became this year's finalists. We recruited and renewed our highest total number of Impact members in our 9-year history, and our grants teams, along with our financial review team, reviewed and selected 10 worthy, exceptional, and inspirational nonprofits representing all 5 of the counties we serve. Tonight is the culmination of all the work that our members have done for the past year. Every one of our 355 members who gave $1,000, joined a committee, or led as a committee chair, helped us attract new members. You have all made this evening possible. Tonight, we finally get to see the fruits of all that work and fulfill our yearly mission of awarding high impact grants to nonprofits serving our local communities. Before we hear from Franz Deladon, our membership enrollment and renewal chair, we have a special video treat for you, in which community members who have actually personally benefited tell us what our impact grants have meant to them. We call this video Voices of Impact, and we are indebted to the 4 past grant recipients, Frontline Arts, Interfaith Food Pantry Network, Project Self-Sufficiency, and Zufall Health Center, who made this video possible. We hope the voices we are about to hear will remind us why we care so much about where our grant money goes. Countless people continue to live better and healthier lives because of the work that Impact 100 Garden State has been doing for the past 9 years. We hope you will appreciate hearing from just a few of these voices now.
Hi, I'm Mark Oldman, an artist with Frontline Paper Program of Frontline Arts. In 2018, the Printmaking Center of New Jersey merged with its physical project, Frontline Arts, originally known as Combat Paper New Jersey, which was the first recipient of the Garden State 100 grant in 2014. Now known as Frontline Paper, our flagship program connects veterans and non-veterans through the transformational practice of making handmade paper for military uniforms, creative writing, and the printmaking via the profound connection over storytelling and participatory art making. We have served upwards of at least 4,000 a year from our veteran program since, and are proud to continue increasing access through our virtual programs in 2020 and beyond. For me, Frontline Paper has become more than just a place to create art. They have become an extension of my family. Sometimes a statement like that can be seen as cliche, often overused. However, for me, that statement is significant. You see, my family's story is somewhat different. Not only are we a veteran Coast Guard family, but we are a special needs family. Both my son and I share similar mental health special needs. And Frontline Paper has helped us find our voice. Whether it's directly through printmaking practices, or as a painter, Frontline Paper provides me and countless others within the community a means to connect and serve in a positive and profound way through art.
Hi, my name is Sandra Benedict, and I'm the Development Director at the Interfaith Food Pantry Network. We are here at St. Anne's Church, where they are holding their monthly farmers market, distributing produce to the people in need in the community. They are one of 29 network partners that IFPN has established over the past several years, thanks in large part to a grant that was given to us by Impact 100 for a refrigerated van. healthy food is really synonymous with refrigerated food very often, so we were so grateful to be able to take the gift from Impact 100 and distribute the produce and the healthy foods and the eggs and low-fat dairy and meats to the 29 network partners in our area. The program just continues to grow, and we're very grateful to Impact.
Produce is great. I mean, I you know, it's expensive these days, and I eat mostly vegetables and, you know, fruit and stuff, so it works out really well.
My name is Lorraine, and I find that the produce from the farmers markets have been fabulous. Stamps generally don't cover enough to buy fruits and vegetables and food, so it's either one or the other. And usually it's the fruits and vegetables that I do without.
I've been getting my groceries at the food pantry in Parsippany. It's all been canned and packaged food. And now that we're getting food from the farmers market, well, the fresh food, I lost over 77 pounds.
I'm 31 years old and I have three children. I just graduated nursing school during the pandemic. I also had a baby during the pandemic. So I have not been able to go back to work just yet. My husband works full time and we're a family of five. I would say Journey is important because those that do not have access to cars, even the disabled, if they can figure out a way to get to the bus, if they live within that town, you know, giving the access to diapers and food. And also learning about PSS programs, you know. Sometimes people want to talk to somebody face-to-face, and they come to a location near us at Farmside Supply, so that's only about a mile from my home, so it's convenient to stop in. I mean, there's been a lot of changes, even Microsoft in general. There's no start button anymore. I mean, there's so many things that are just simple things that I wouldn't probably understand. You know, a lot of us have Mac, you know, technology now. There's so many resources at PSS that my family has taken advantage of.
Hi everyone, I'm France Deladon, Membership Chair. What a year we've had. 355 members, enabling us to award three impact grants of $100,000 and seven merit grants of $8,000. New records for us, amazing, all thanks to you. Every new member you brought on by hosting a meet and mingle info gathering or by inviting your relationships to one, by guiding them to join us directly online, by introducing us to new organizations, including our new community partners in the COCO and the Morris County Chamber of Commerce. And every event and press release you posted in your local media helped us get to this level of success. And so, as we now embark on our 10th year of membership and grant making, let's make it the strongest yet. We invite you now to use our pop-up poll to please let us know if you're in for 2022. So don't be surprised if you see the pop-up poll over my face. This is normal. But know that as soon as you click on one of the three options offered or on the X at the top right of your screen, it will go away. And here are your options. One, tell us that you'd like to renew your membership. Or two, tell us that you'd like to join us as a new member. Three, that you'd like more information so that one of us can contact you. Thank you for your pledge to be a part of Impact 100's 10th year. It's been a great honor to serve as your membership chair, along with Merle Johnson and Marsha Hunter these past 3 years. I'm incredibly grateful to them. I'm equally as grateful to our fabulous 2021 membership team. However, the time to pass the baton has come. As such, we couldn't be more excited to welcome and work with our new membership co-chairs, Anne Stackenfeld and Lisa Wahlberg. Anne and Lisa are experienced Impact 100 volunteers, leaders in our expanded nonprofit community, talented professionals, and all around terrific. Be sure to look for them at our September membership kickoff event. Thank you all again for this incredible team effort in 2021. The perfect segue here is to now recognize our valued sponsors who helped defray our general operating expenses throughout the year. We are infinitely grateful for their loyal support, particularly so to our generous longstanding gold sponsors, Crum & Forster and BNY Mellon Wealth Management, who will now say a few words.
Thank you and good evening to all of our Impact 100 Garden State members and the tremendous nonprofit finalists we are here to recognize. I am extremely happy to be here, not only as a member of this great organization, but as Corporate Social Responsibility Manager of Crum & Forster. We all wish this wonderful and celebratory evening could be held in person, and I know that day is coming soon. Through my first year of Impact 100 Garden State and serving on many of its committees, I have learned a lot about our community's needs and am amazed at the work that the nonprofits are doing throughout the state. I have seen firsthand the positive and lasting effects this organization and its membership continue to have on so many people, and I've made a few great friends along the way. My company, Crum & Forster, a nearly 200-year-old property and casualty and accident health insurer, firmly believes that corporate social responsibility is at the heart of doing good business. Our wide-ranging programs demonstrate our passion for driving positive change among the diverse groups that we serve through charitable giving, community service, and engagement. In 2020, Crum & Forster donated $1.5 million, primarily to local communities around the country affected by the economic impact of COVID-19, where our employees live and work. Importantly, we believe in doing well by doing good. Crum & Forster is proud to continue to support Impact 100 Garden State, and I'm honored to be counted among these remarkable and inspirational women. On behalf of Impact 100 Garden State and Crum & Forster, I applaud all of you for your hard work and dedication and wish every one of tonight's finalists the best of luck. Thank you for your ongoing and unwavering commitment to the state of New Jersey.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us. I appreciate the opportunity to welcome everyone to the 2021 Annual Awards meeting to celebrate our wonderful finalists and our collective impact in the communities that we serve. In 2014, I joined Impact 100 Garden State and encouraged my company, BNY Mellon Wealth Management, to come online as a proud corporate sponsor. At Bank of New York Mellon, we have been actively advising families through challenging world events for more than 200 years, and we guide our clients in how to invest, protect, and plan for their wealth now and for future generations. Just as our business dates back two centuries, so does our legacy to citizenship and service that drives our partnerships with community organizations like Impact 100 and our philanthropic mission to build a workforce in the future. Last year, BNY Mellon and its employees donated over $34 million to help realize this mission, and the employees provided over 50,000 hours of volunteer service in the communities where they live and work. I would like to congratulate our 10 finalists for their innovative programs and for the wonderful work they do in their communities. I hope you will join us again in 2022 as we strive to make an even bigger impact in the lives of New Jersey's most vulnerable. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Louise Murray, one of the 100 plus impact members involved in bringing these 10 finalists to our membership for a vote. This night is an evening of such joy for all of us as we conclude the important work of vetting applicants and asking for your vote. Every member of Impact 100 Garden State has brought us to this day by contributing $1,000 or more. 100% of these $1,000 donations is being awarded tonight to our nonprofits. Bravo. Along the way, some members took leadership roles that enabled us to designate these 10 outstanding organizations as finalists. These impact leaders include Jennifer Avers and Cindy Fleischer, who led efforts to host several interactive meetings with applicants and then followed up on all applicant inquiries. Pat Roschkind, my colleague, for her leadership as the two of us trained members to review applications and later supported the finalists to prepare their information for members' vote. Special thanks to Lee Bash, who is a marvel at arranging each of our grant review committees to have a good balance of new and veteran members. Lee, Pat, and I deeply appreciate the work of the Financial Review Committee for their meticulous study and work during the grant review process. All of us want to recognize Suzanne Herman and Arlene Lipsman, who have led our efforts for over 4 years to monitor grant recipients' use of impact funding. Suzanne and Arlene are retiring this year, and we look forward to working with the new co-chairs, Betty Schultz and Lori Wilson. Now it is my honor to pass the screen to one of the 2019 recipients who will share his experience working with Impact 100 Garden State. Thank you to everyone.
Hey everyone, this is Mark Dinglassen, the Executive Director of CUMAC. We are an anti-hunger organization based in Passaic County, and we're also a 2019 Impact 100 Garden State grant recipient. First, to all of the Impact members, thanks for all the work that you continue to do in all the communities we're serving. But this message tonight is for the finalists. To all of the finalists, I've been where you are, so I know how stressful and exciting this moment can be. So I want to say congratulations, because the very fact that you're part of this night is a testament to the power of your programs and the strength of your teams. And I want to urge everyone to not let tonight end with just a check. Continue to call your Impact 100 Garden State advocates and supporters. Stay in touch with them. Impact 100 Garden State members are some of our greatest volunteers and supporters at CUMAC. And throughout our relationship with Impact, some of them have become my dearest friends. So call them, text them, and email them. And if they ever tell you that you're calling too much, just do what I do. Tell them it's their fault because they made you a finalist. Congratulations, finalists. And now I'll turn it over to Debbie for the moment we've all been waiting for.
Thank you so much, Mark. Your messages to our members and finalists mean so much because they perfectly capture the special relationship we maintain with our grant recipients. And congratulations again to you and your wife on the birth of your baby girl, Lily Grace. Love her name. Let's review in alphabetical order our 10 finalists and their programs. First one, Adult Day Center of Somerset County, Project Respect. The Boys and Girls Club of Patterson and Passaic, Health and Wellness Program. Children's Literacy Initiative, Partnership to Nurture Passaic First Graders Biliteracy Post-COVID-19. Community Options Enterprises, Workforce Development for People with Disabilities. Family Promise of Sussex County, Housing Hope Because Everyone Deserves a Home. Family Promise Union County, Road to Success, Empowering Families Through Transportation. Literacy New Jersey, Adult Digital Literacy Programs in Union and Sussex Counties. NorWestCap, Expanding Economic Opportunity for Women and Families. Partners for Women and Justice, Empower Sexual and Relational Violence on Campus and in the LGBTQ plus community. And Wharton Institute for the Performing Arts, Patterson Music Project, New Neighborhood After School Program at PS 16. Our members have watched all 10 finalist presentations and read their program summaries in order to make an educated and thoughtful vote. The votes are all in, and they have been tabulated by our accountants, who are the only ones who know the results. Our three grant recipients will be announced in no particular order. After each award, we will give each grant recipient the opportunity to speak. Melanie, may I have the first envelope, please? Special thanks to Charlotte Grushkin, daughter of member Trish Grushkin, whose handiwork created these lovely folders for us. I am trembling. Are you as eager as I am to open this up? I'm going to open it up. The first $100,000 grant is awarded to Community Options Enterprises, Workforce Development for People with Disabilities. Accepting the award on behalf of Community Options Enterprises is Dina Casalaspro, Managing Director. Dina?
Thank you so much, Debbie, and thank you to everyone at Impact 100. On behalf of Community Options Enterprises, this is an amazing grant. It's going to help us hire a job developer who will help individuals with disabilities in the five counties find a job and work in integrated, competitive employment and help them achieve the goals they're looking to reach. So again, thank you to everyone at Impact 100 for choosing Community Options as one of the award recipients.
Thank you, Dina. Our second Impact $100,000 grant is awarded to NorWestCap, Expanding Economic Opportunity for Women and Families. Accepting the award on behalf of NorWestCap is Mark Vallee, Chief Executive Officer. Mark?
I can't believe it. That was awesome. Oh man, we are so excited. Oh my God. We are totally excited. We're so grateful to Impact 100. You're amazing, generous, and passionate volunteers. You guys are unbelievable. We were running around, we couldn't click on the button. We were so excited. But I have to say thanks to some of the people in this room. Heather, thank you so much. Chris, thank you so much for pulling this together. Libby, Dawn, Carol, the whole CLTC team. It's an amazing team. They do so much for the women that we serve and really transform lives. You know, NorWestCap does programming and education, employment, in health, in financial empowerment, in housing community development, and in volunteerism. But this program really, really represents what we're best at. We had big challenges coming into COVID. We had to totally transform how the organization does business. We've moved to a completely data-driven process to tell our story and expand our impact. Literally overnight, we did that. We had to better communicate what we do to people, and we had to improve customer service, and that's where this program comes in. We had to create a One Norwest Cap theme where if you come in our door, it doesn't matter which one of our dozens of programs you get access to, we're going to follow you. We're going to connect you to all the resources that you need. And this grant exemplifies that process. So we no longer have to worry about the government red tape that regulates who we can serve. We now have the resources we need to not turn away the women that need support. So thank you so much. We are super grateful.
Yes. So great.
Now we're not drowning our sorrows. Now that's celebratory.
That was great, Mark. I think that all that excitement from your organization just transformed us for a few seconds. Sorry about that. All right, and the third and final $100,000 impact grant is awarded to Family Promise of Sussex Housing Hope, because everyone deserves a home. Accepting the award on behalf of Family Promise of Sussex is Chris Botto, Executive Director. Chris?
Hi, thank you. Thank you for this incredible opportunity. We're excited and honored to have been chosen for this generous award. I want to take a minute to say thank you to Lisa, Rita, Martha, and Valerie, who gave us so much guidance throughout this whole process. I also want to thank my board for all their support, and I want to give a huge thank you to all of my staff for their hard work, their dedication, and the passion that they bring to the office every single day. So just to talk a little bit about what this grant is, sadly for the fourth consecutive year, homelessness has increased nationwide. And in New Jersey, a 9% increase has been seen over the past 2 years. Due to the impact of COVID-19, homelessness within our state continues to grow. And during 2020, over 80% of our renter households were at risk of becoming homeless. The unsheltered homeless population rose by 7%, with even higher rates for unsheltered families with children, who are at a rate of 10%. COVID-19 has been so much more than a health crisis. It's robbed so many of our neighbors of their jobs, of their homes, their social networks, and their sense of peace and safety. Our Housing Hope program will provide a robust prevention measure to tackle housing insecurity across the spectrum. So again, thank you, Impact 100 Garden State. We greatly appreciate your support, and we look forward to the important work that will come ahead. Thank you.
Wow, wasn't that wonderful? How could you not renew your membership after hearing what these grants mean to these recipients? And if you are not currently a member, wouldn't you want to be a part of making a night like tonight possible? Emily, could you pull up that poll again for us? We want to give our members one more opportunity to renew their membership now. I know the poll is in front of my face, but it will disappear when you either answer it or if you just X out of it. So, but please answer it, take a few seconds to do so. And if you've already done so in the first poll, thank you so much. Congratulations again to Community Options Enterprises, Family Promise of Sussex County, and Norwest Cap. Our grant administration teams look forward to working with you throughout the term of your grant. As Mark so eloquently stated, our relationship with you goes way beyond the grant money. To our 7 finalists who did not get a major grant this evening, we so appreciate the time and effort you put into applying and in working with us to get ready for tonight's event. I know I speak for many of our members when I say it was so difficult completing the ballot this year, and I wish we could award a major impact grant to every one of you tonight. We hope that the $8,000 merit grant each of you will receive will help support the incredible work that you all do. And we sincerely hope you will apply again in 2022. And to our members, if you would like to support these nonprofits, their wish lists will remain on our website. So please learn about the many ways that you can donate your time and treasure with them. Wendy Steele, who founded the first Impact Chapter in Cincinnati 20 years ago, recently wrote about the past year. As each of us gives generously, we become the light for someone else. Each time we give, we are effectively placing another rung on the ladder by which we will climb out of this. Mr. Rogers taught us to overcome our fears in the darkest days by looking for the helpers. As I look at the Impact 100 community, I see you, the helpers. To everyone on this Zoom, we see you, the helpers that Mr. Rogers told us to look for. You all continue to be light shining in the darkness. Thank you so much for all that you do for Impact and for our communities. I would also like to thank our members of the annual awards committee who are here with me tonight, with the exception of Mary Jane Robertson, whom I am hoping will turn her video on so that we can see her in North Carolina. Mary Jane, are you there? Oh, she's there.
Hi. Hi, everybody. Hi, Impact 100 members. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mary Jane, for chairing this event for so many years. Thank you, Mary Jane Lunt, behind me, for hosting us this evening, and Emily Schaefer of grapevine.org for once again serving as our Zoom guardian angel. Please remember these wonderful women who made tonight's program possible. I can never thank them enough. Good night. Have a wonderful and safe summer, and hope to see you all in person this fall. Thanks, everyone, and good night.
Congratulations.